Hey guys, my name is Hogan, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to install Google Analytics onto your WordPress website. So Google Analytics is important so you can track how many visitors are coming to your website, what they're doing, and how your site is performing. Now you can also view the analytics within the dashboard of your WordPress, so it's super convenient, and this is a must-have plugin for your WordPress website, blog, or e-commerce store. So without much further ado, let's get started. The first thing that you'll need to do is log in to your Google account. Then the second thing you'll need to do is search for Google Analytics and click on Enter. Now you can click on the first result here. Now if you have an account already, it's going to take you within your dashboard area. If you don't have an account, I think you can click on Sign Up, or I think it's called Start Measuring, and that's going to take you to where you can create your new account. So you can scroll down here. If you have an account already, click on Admin and click on Create Accounts. Okay, so everyone should be on this page now. For the account name, you can put your business name or whatever you want. So this one, I'm just going to call it Analytics Demo Tutorial. So you can scroll down here and uncheck these if you want to. I'm just going to click on Next. So we're going to select Web, scroll down, on Next. So for the website name, this one is just going to be Site Tutorial. So this one could be just your website domain name or whatever you want. You want to copy the domain URL of your website. So copy that and come back here and just paste that in. So depending on whether or not you have the HTTPS, then you want to select it. Okay. And also just delete that from there. Delete that as well. For the industry, I'm just going to put in business, and reporting time zone, I'm going to set in Australia and set in Melbourne. Then I'm going to click on create. I'm going to select Australia here and then accept the terms, scroll down, and then I'm going to accept that, and I accept. All right. So that has created your new account. Now, the next thing you want to do is you want to go to your WordPress dashboard area and you want to hover over plugins, click on add new. Then here we want to search for Google Analytics dashboard, click on enter. Now there are a few Google Analytics plugins that you can install, but I personally like this one by Exact Metrics because it's just simple and lightweight. I'm going to install now. And then click on activate. Once you've done that, then you can see Google Analytics on the left here. You can click that. And we want to authorize the plugin. Okay, click on get access code. And then you want to click on your Google account, which you've just created the analytics for. Okay, click on allow. Copy over the code. Come back here. Paste it in here and save access code. So that's going to link your WordPress website to your Google Analytics account, right? So you can actually view the analytics by clicking on dashboard here, and you can see the stats here. So it's not going to load yet. It's going to take a couple of hours for that to actually populate. And if you want to see the full stats and stuff like that, then you can go back here and you can click on your home. All right, so you can see all your stats, your users, click on real time, you can check your audience and things like that, right? So what you wanna do lastly is to actually come back here to Google Analytics, click on the tracking code, and you wanna exclude tracking. So you don't really wanna track yourself, and maybe if you have editors or authors for your WordPress website, you probably don't wanna track that because it's just gonna give you inconsistent data. So we want to sort of just tick all that, and you can select these ones if you have these people as well. Click on save changes. So that's pretty much it. I also recommend checking out my SEO tutorial and Yoast SEO tutorial to learn how to get traffic to your website, which I'll link down in the description below. And just in case, for those of you who are still building your WordPress website and you want to learn how to fully customize and build a WordPress website, I'll leave the link to that tutorial as well. So thank you, and see you guys in the next tutorial.